Hi, and welcome to Maxell. My name is Sajad, and today I'd like to show to you the MAXL1 lecture capture station. We recently used the lecture capture station to record a tutorial video for the projector blending tool. If you'd like to view this video, you can see the link in the description below. So, what is the MAXL1? Well, it's Maxell's answer to a fully automated and truly collaborative solution in the lecture capture arena. Lecture capture has been around for some time now, but with the Maxell's lecture capture, you can share content and annotations across a wide area network. You can access rich content from anywhere. You can record and stream three channels simultaneously. Currently, we're recording two channels, but I will show you the three channel recording later on. You can stream to platforms such as YouTube, Facebook, Ustream, Twitch if you're a gamer. And the main thing is it's got an easy to use graphical user interface. You're able to switch content, you're able to capture your visuals, you can access it from the library, you can change your recording layout, and you can also make the conference call to another MAXL1 unit. So where is it used? Well, we know the MAXL1 is used in schools and colleges, higher educations and universities. It's also used in corporate for live streaming in boardroom meetings and also to record the conferences. We've also had uses for it in police departments and courts for recording hearings. In hospitality, we've had interest from orthodontists to record practice, hospitals across multiple sites to share knowledge, and of course training videos. Who does the MAXL1 benefit? Well, it benefits students, it benefits lecturers and universities. We know that there's a scientific study which shows that the attention span is approximately 20 minutes, and after that obviously you're bound to miss out some information. Students learn differently as well. Some students learn better in a visual manner, others learn better in audible manner. The MAXL1 empowers students to become self-directed learners because you're able to access this content however many times you want, wherever you want. Lecturers, well, this supports long distance learning. It's basically making content accessible to everybody. And there's an interesting quote by Benjamin Bloom, and it says, "It makes no sense to expect students to take the same amount of time to achieve the same objectives." Universities are also able to provide students with a more comprehensive learning platform. And you can increase revenue by more off-campus learning. So I'm just going to run you through the four main features: content switching, recording, streaming and uploading, video replay whilst recording, and the interactive remote classroom. So content switching, very, very simple. I'm just going to bring up the menu bar. So the touch of a button, the menu bar comes up. And to switch content, we simply press on the icon and you will now see my camera. We've got a whiteboard down at the bottom as well, with or without grids. Annotation here, you can select whichever color you want. You've got various thicknesses. And that's your content switching. Let's go back to our main input. So typically you'd have a camera connected on channel 2, channel 1 would be your PC or laptop, and your channel 3 would be something like a document camera. And of course you can customize this. So as you can see on the screen, we've got channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. And if you see my menu, you can see I've customized with an image of a camera, and the third input I will show you in a second. The next thing I'd like to talk about is the recording and layout. So what you will currently see on the screen is the main screen will be the PowerPoint presentation, and then you will have my secondary input, which is the camera. So what I will now do is do a 50-50 split. So if I want to have it side by side, or I can just have the main content and get rid of any secondary input. Now, if I want to introduce a third input, all I have to do is select the third input layout. And what I'm going to use is I'm actually going to use my camera. So this is my phone, and I'm going to use this as a camera for the third input. So you will see in a second that the third input should come in, and what you should see is some Maxell earphones. Sorry, I'll try and hold this as still as I can. RFID blocker card, also by Maxell. Let's just zoom in there and get a closer look. So what you can see is some skulls on there. Some very cool looking earphones by Maxell. And what I will do is I will now stop that and go back to a two screen recording, because we don't need the third input now. And also you can see on the menu just above the recording layout is the stop button, the pause button, and a snapshot. So if I want to get a snapshot, I'll just simply do that, and that now takes a snapshot of the screen. So if we want to do some annotations on the screen, we can do some annotations and also take a snapshot. And once you've taken your snapshot, you can then access it from the library. So this is the one that we've just taken, and that was one I took earlier. Exit out of the library, and we're back onto our main screen. The next feature I'd like to talk to you about is the instant playback whilst recording. So the Maxell 1 allows you to select a video clip which you may have recorded in the previous month, week, day, and you can play it back whilst you're still recording. So this can also be useful in a scientific experiment which you've just done, and you'd like to go back to see what the result of it was. So I'm just going to actually go into the library now and play something back which I recorded for the projector blending video. So this is the video over here. So if we just skip a little bit forward, and we can see of the white area. There you go, that's the video there. And you can see at the end there, we've got a blended image. So we'll just come back out of the library now. So that is that's instant playback whilst recording. The interactive whiteboard, as you saw earlier. So we've got the whiteboard over here. Again, annotations, different thickness of pens. You can do a snapshot. Again, save that snapshot, access it from your library. And we go back to the main screen. The next feature I'd like to talk to you about is the remote classroom collaboration. Now, this feature is unique to the Maxell 1. So what you're able to do is you're able to have a Maxell 1 in one classroom and a Maxell 1 in another classroom. This could be on the same campus, this could be on a different campus. You can have it in one meeting room and another meeting room. What you're able to then do is call one another and share content, share ideas, and annotate at the same time. Obviously, whilst you're doing all this, you're doing the annotations, you're able to live stream this as well. It will get recorded to the 1 terabyte internal hard drive. You can then upload it to a platform of your choice at a later stage. So this is very, very unique. So this is typically how a scheduled recording would work. The Maxell 1 would read from your Outlook calendar or your Moodle calendar or Google calendar, whichever calendar supports iCal format. It would then, whichever time it's scheduled for, so let's just say you have a 10 a.m. recording, it would then record at that time. It would also live stream it if you've chosen to live stream it to whichever platform of your choice, whether you've chosen to live stream it on YouTube, Ustream, Facebook, whatever it is. And once it's finished recording, it then uploads it to a platform of your choice via FTP. The Maxell 1 also allows you to record and live stream your Zoom meetings. So this will be a typical layout of a teacher's home office, and then you've got the students who would be connecting in, and you can make this bi-directional because the content which will be shared will go back into the Zoom meeting that will then be live streamed out to anyone else who is viewing the content. Let's have a quick look at the connectivity on the Maxell 1. So let's have a look at the front first. From left to right, you've got the audio indicators, then you've got the front audio output port, you have a HDMI in, you have a USB type A in, so the Maxell 1 can be configured for you to come along with a USB, plug it into the front, press record, the recording will then be saved onto the USB, you can stop recording and take your USB out and walk away with the content at the end of the recording. So the square buttons, you've got the recording start button, you've got the recording stop button, you have the video switcher button, so you're able to switch content from the front of the Maxell 1. You also have the info button, the projector power button, so you can actually control a projector which is also plugged into the back of the Maxell 1. And then to the very right hand side, you've got the main power button. Let's have a closer look at the back of the Maxell 1 for connectivity. So again, from left to right, you have the power input. You have your SDIs 1, 2, and 3. To the right of that, you have the VGA or computer input. Below that, you have your HDMI 1, 2, and 3 inputs. Then to the right of the inputs, you have your outputs, which is your computer output. And below that, your HDMI output. Then you have your mic in and your audio in and out. To the right of that, you have your Phoenix connector with the balanced audio. Then you have your USB type A. Then if you are using an interactive projector or an interactive IFPD, you can actually use the Maxell 1 as a pass-through. So you can connect your interactive devices via USB type A or type B. Then to the right of the interactivity connectors, you have your network connections. So you have the WAN port, and you have three LAN ports, so you can use this either to connect to a computer, or if you've got network cameras you'd like to connect, you can connect your network cameras via the network ports. Then you have your RS-232 control ports. So very, very important. A lot of organizations have Crestron, Extron, and you can control this device via control port. Then you have your DIDO port, and to your very right, you have the Bluetooth antenna port. So let's have a quick look at the key points of the Maxell 1. So it's important to remember, with the Maxell 1, there's no additional costs or annual fees. There's no cost for streaming, there's no cost for the conference calling, there's no additional fees, no license fees. It's just a one-time cost, and the product is yours, and you can tailor it to your environment. You have the flexibility to work with many learning management systems and VMS on the market. You're not tied into any sort of contract. The Maxell 1 can take 11 inputs. This is a combination of SDI, HDMI, and network. Conference calling is simply over IP. There's no additional license or software required for this. So the Maxell 1 can be used with existing hardware of other brands. You're not confined to just Maxell. So the camera we're using right now is a DSLR Nikon camera. The audio input is via a Sennheiser wireless mic. And my third camera input was actually my mobile phone. So you can see it's a very, very flexible system, and it allows you to connect many different devices. We have an easy to use on-screen menu, which can be completely customized. And it has RS-232 to integrate with control systems. Many organizations these days use control systems such as Extron and Crestron, and you're able to drop the MAXL1 straight into the setup and configure it with control commands via RS-232. Thank you for watching my presentation. If you have any questions on the MAXL1 or indeed any of the other products which we sell, please do not hesitate to contact me on 077-8757-2976. Thank you.